about on Morgan and renting them out. It's like, but I really specifically would like to talk about that I got into the City of San Jose pre-approved ADU vendor program and created this all-electric ADU design that could pretty much fit anybody's single-family backyard. It's 476 square feet, one bathroom, and it's a little popular model. And we've been able to make it work by in multiple different locations, even though it's pretty much the same design. We do a site-specific site plan for each property, but the rest of the plan set and documents are the same from one location to another. At this point, this particular ADU is pre-approved in San Jose, Cupertino, and Fremont, but I do have ADUs pre-approved in 16 jurisdictions, and I'm about to get approved in 12 more jurisdictions. So pretty soon, by the end of this year, we'll be pre-approved in at least 28 different jurisdictions. Next slide. So this particular ADU, little simple floor plan, our goal in general was to promote ADUs, but also promote all-electric ADUs, and so the decision was to create a well-designed all-electric ADU that could fit in the majority of lots, would comply to a lot of municipal requirements, and it should be pretty similar to the existing house. So, you know, looking at what was in our Bay Area housing stock and what kind of works within those parameters created this design. Next slide. And part of being able to go all electric is including things, and some of this is from the 2019 code, so some of this will now change, including PVs, which for this particular ADU was 1.64 kilowatt DC, and so now with the new codes, we would be required to do it. Insulating and creating high vaulted ceilings, you know, slope ceilings, so that this tiny space is felt a little bigger. We're using heat pump water heaters and HVAC heat pump typical mini splits, putting induction ranges with electric ovens, and then to make it work pretty much on any property, the Title 24 report is done for all orientations, and then we do have to do a separate report when there's a different climate zone. Next slide. All right, and I just want to show you a couple of pictures of the ADU, this particular ADU completed. Next slide for the inside, it's only 476 square feet, but it does feel pretty spacious, and the next slide has some pictures of it in some other municipalities and some other locations, and we do have a mirror image plan so that the homeowner can choose whether they want it oriented in one direction or another. So one of the things on our Plus Delta today was to talk about what's been working and what needs improvement. So next slide, I have some things that I really feel have been working for us. One, of course, the state must now require municipalities to allow ADUs. It really opened up the ability to do more ADUs. We have found that homeowners really want them, and I heard a statistic earlier this year that 22% of all permits in California are ADUs. Since getting into the City of San Jose pre-approved ADU program, it's been a good program in that homeowners come directly to us to purchase our plans and our services instead of the municipality giving them out for free. This gives them the opportunity to choose who to hire, promote good designs, a variation of options in streamlining and condensing that plan review process. And since we've been involved in the San Jose pre-approved program since 2020, in 2021, the statistic in San Jose was actually that 38% of all permits were actually ADUs. I don't have the 2022 statistic yet. So all of this is working. Where is there room for improvement? Next slide. Well, same thing, although the state law, you know, has required municipalities to allow ADUs, and I think a lot of architects are feeling this pain, not all are complying or are making it difficult for homeowners, and so that the homeowners end up giving up on the process. And sometimes the process is a little more lengthy than they're supposed to doing, they're complying to that first 30 days, but then sometimes they're not complying. So it seems like there's some variation from municipality to municipality, and knowing that as an architect when you're going into these different locations is pretty important. And again, they can also differ greatly in their interpretation of code and the state law, and that makes it difficult when I need to advise homeowners on what can we do on their particular property. Some of the examples that I have found is how they interpret multiple buildings on the same lot in relationship to like fire rating and the CDC versus the CRC. So for example, the CDC says in single-family lots, you know, if you have multiple buildings on it, there's no fire rating, but then you've got the CRC. It doesn't say that specifically, but what it does have is it has the Table R 302.1 that discusses the fire separation, and a lot of these municipalities are putting in an imaginary fire separation line between the two buildings and then requiring that distance to be greater than the 6 feet that we see from state law because of fire separation. We're requiring fire rating on the primary residence in order to get the distance closer. So it can vary from one municipality to another. I talk to building officials all the time, and first thing I ask them is, what is your interpretation of this in the distance between a primary residence and a detached ADU? Another thing is how floor area is calculated. Most of the municipalities seem to be saying that they're calculating the floor area from the exterior wall, but then the CDC also says that we calculate floor area from the interior wall. We're not sure exactly, you know, again, it's another question we ask every municipality, well, how are you going to calculate the floor area for this? And so we had to make a decision that when we're reusing an ADU from one municipality to another, we're just going to give it that outside dimension for the floor area. And then another new thing that's happened to me this year that has made things difficult as far as, you know, code interpretation is that even though I have ADUs that are more than 400 square feet, some of them are trying to apply the tiny home appendix AQ, especially when we're doing things like lofts or floor areas on that they're using appendix AQ, and just to know that sometimes they're going to refer to that even if your ADU is 500 square feet and not 400 square feet, which is the definition of a tiny home. So that's kind of where I'm at.